A caution comes out for AJ Allmendinger's tire during green flag pit stops while leaders Kyle Busch and Alex Bowman pitted. Freddie, spot on, spot off.
If I was 1,000% spot off, I saw it on the last time, I got to be a billion percent spot off here. This was the most dangerous situation we've seen yet with this deal.
Yeah.
You know, you got a tire rolling around the racetrack
cars at speed,
you know, and a confined location. You know, you're going to, I mean, listen, I don't know what the fix is. And I've talked to a couple tire changers and it simply sounds like the pressure to be fast is outweighing the need to get the tire tight. And some of these guys, some of the more inexperienced guys that are doing pit road or on pit road, can't tell if the tire's tight. So you think it's tight, you leave pit road, and guess what? It's not. So, you know, there's a lot of factors in that everybody, it boils down to everybody, like Brett said, the movement on pit road is so much this year that, you know, small mistakes not used to cost you one or two spots. Now they cost you 10 or 15. So the window of how fast you've got to be, we've got teams inventing new styles of pit stops with this deal. So I think the pressure of how fast you want to be, guys are dropping the jack a little bit too fast before the wheel gets completely tightened up. You know, the changer is just hitting the lug and coming off before it's too tight. So, you know, it's just the onus on being the fastest is causing these guys to leave these wheels loose. And it's not something new. This is not new in the sport. We had wheels loose every week last year, but the problem is you got a chance to fix it. You know, you go out there and feel it. Okay, I got a loose wheel. I got to come back to pit road and fix it before your damn wheel falls off and you lose half your team for a month.
But if your wheel was loose last year, you had a 60 to 80% chance that it would stay on and be fine.
Because
you had five lug nuts on that particular wheel. And if you hit three in a triangle, you actually could run a full run on it, right? So that's a 60%, 80% if you got four.
I mean, they were doing four on purpose most of the time.
Right.
You know,
yeah.
Like
to get off pit road faster. Yeah, so that's where this came from. But Casey, this could be a show in and of itself. I really wish we had a jackman in here, a tire changer in here, a crew chief in here, an owner in here, a NASCAR representative in here, because to me, this warrants a gigantic discussion. This tire came off when AJ Allmendinger left pit road, and we had a long lapse from the time the tire came off until the caution came out. And if a vehicle running 160 plus miles an hour hits that tire, I don't know what happens. I don't know if the tire goes over the backside of the casino or if it goes through the driver's windshield. I don't know what can happen here. So when we have a tire loose, the NASCAR spotter has to call the tire out and the NASCAR tower has to immediately respond. So we had an error there where there was a big lapse, and that's what concerns me the most about the situation. When I look at it, though, as another tire came off, Denny Hamlin's tire came off. Like every race, somebody's losing a tire. The tire changer, the jackman, something's going on. I mean, I heard there was one scenario yesterday where the one lug nut actually fell out of the gun and the guy didn't know it and he hit the tire. He thought the lug nut was on the tire. And when the car left, the lug nut was laying on the ground. Okay. So if we have those situations occurring, I had a long debate with Jeff Burton about this. I don't know if you guys were around when I was talking to him about it the other week when we were at Richmond. And I was basically saying, Jeff, we've got to do something here. This isn't working. And he's like, well, every other form of motorsports in the world makes it work with one lug nut. Why can't we? Well, I don't know, Jeff, but right now we cannot. So what do we do to make this stop? I mean, when you look at a team like Joe Gibbs Racing, everybody on that team is a Joe Gibbs Racing employee, okay? Colleague Racing. None of those guys are Colleague Racing employees. They're all Trackhouse Racing employees. So we have got a tire changer, a jackman, and now our crew chief for AJ Allmendinger that is suspended when two of those guys are just subcontracted out, right? So, I mean, it's a very fickle situation on what I think is fair. And I'll go back and say this again. I said this to Jeff Burton. Four races is too long. And guess what you're bringing in to take that guy's place?
A less experienced guy.
A guy that's not good enough to be a starter on Sunday. So because we had a personal foul on a safety on our defense, we're kicking our quarterback and our running back out too. I don't agree with the way NASCAR is handling these suspensions and these particular things. And, I mean, we talked about this week freaking one at Daytona. We saw two, three guys lose their tire there. We cannot keep doing this. Something bad is going to happen.
So what's an adequate suspension?
I don't know the answer to the question. I wish I did. I can't say that getting rid of your best tire changer who made a freaking... The lug nut's laying on the ground.
Which is not supposed... The lug nut is supposed to stay in the gun.
Tell
the,
me
the
how guns the are
you that think? Happens. What about the crew chief? Do you think the crew chief has any say in if no the tire falls off either?
Down, you're right. If it's no different than me walking down to TJ and unplugging his radio and throwing it off the back of the roof and saying, hey, good luck spotting without your radio.
We've got exciting news. OfferPad wants to buy your home. Go to OfferPad.com right now and tell them all about it. You'll receive a cash offer within 24 hours.